goal scored on the power play with a red wing in the box. Jakob Kindle for delay of game for clearing the puck over the glass. And now a 2-for-3 power play of the night. Goes back to work looking for a little insurance. Gets left Perry, Ryan, Boschman, Fowler. Way back to Boschman. No shooting lane, so he just sends it deep. Jonathan Erickson's got it to run off the skate. Bonino almost up with it. And now Everton. He'll counter shorthanded. And again, both teams have surrendered 5 shorthanded goals this year. Let's see the Red Wings take a shot here. And Fowler at the wheel. For Perry, who flips it in wide of the net. Brendan Smith is there. And he finds a lane to clear. Remaining in the football penalty, just over 3 to go in regulation time. Solani nearly stole it. DeKaiser's got it, and he'll send this Duck power play back. Ben Lovejoy. Now it's Berleski's feet again. He assisted on the goal by Solani, played out by Everton. Lovejoy, who's been a good addition, picked up for a fifth rounder from Pittsburgh, sends it down. That's an icing call against the Duck power play.
Really unorganized, tentative power play here for Anaheim with the lead. It almost appears as they're overly cautious not to make a mistake here, as they almost seem more interested in whittling the 2 minutes off the clock than putting a push on.
And now Datsyuk and Zetterberg come out together on the penalty kill.
They combined for a shorthanded goal in their playoff clinching win in Dallas on Saturday night.
Damo Solani will flip it towards Howard. Dozen seconds remaining in the football penalty as Zetterberg heads up ice. Flipping it down past Hiller. Surrey wrapping it around and out comes Bobby Ryan. Detroit back at full strength. The couple out of the box creates the turnover. And Datsyuk slowed up there by Boschman. Winnick will dump it in and give chase. He'll lean on Cromwell. Zetterberg back to help out. And now Kindle gets a little room. Under 2 to go. Leaves it for Zetterberg. Over the line, it's Applicator. Out of the net comes Howard. And the Ducks are able to flip it back to center. So the extra attacker is out with over 90 seconds to go.
Datsyuk and Zetterberg have been on the ice for a long time already here for the Red Wings.
A steal by Cogliano, and DeKaiser got it back. Now up on the right side for Friends. Bonino couldn't get it past him, and it's DeKaiser moving up. He'll throw it across, deflected.
Well, the Ducks have the puck in good possession. Bonino can't get to it behind the net, and it's just a simple play by DeKaiser as he throws it to the front, and you see Applicator there, and Hiller able to make the stop and glove it as a timeout is called here as the Wings can get some rest for their top guys.
So the Red Wings call the timeout. Game is brought to you by Chevrolet. Find new roads.
If a game is about speed, then Andrew Cogliano has it in spades. He's been the best Duck forward in my estimation tonight. His speed has pushed the Wings' defense backwards. He's created chances. Look at him out wide here in the third period, forcing Jimmy Howard for the stop. He's done an excellent job on the penalty kill, and your electric player of the game is Andrew Cogliano.
A couple of goals against the Red Wings in the regular season. He's been a threat to score tonight. The Masters and Trophy nominee from this team. But still some work to be done for the Ducks. 68 seconds on the clock. Jimmy Howard's on the bench for an extra attacker. And what does Zetterberg, Franzen, and company have left in the tank?
Gets lots of 48% face-off men. feature two stars lining up for a crucial draw with just over a minute left.
Nyquist, part of this group of six for Mike Babcock. One by Datsyuk. Back to the point, Cromwell. Across it goes. The shot tipped by Franzen. Centered in front of Trinick. Off the glass. And it's out. Cromwell has to sprawl to knock it away from Saku Koivu. We're into the final minute of regulation time. Will Taylor Salani's ball put goal early in the period stand up? Turned over at center and played back in by Winnick. Cagliari's on the ice with the empty net. Kindle for Zetterberg. Over the line they come, sliding in on Hillard. And the puck cleared high in the box and out. And is it enough for icing? Just enough. 26.2 on the clock and a face-off back in the Duck zone.
They can't change players, but they can call timeout. But you see Bruce Boudreau behind the bench, and he says, no, I want it to go on. He knows he can't change the players, so he's going to leave his five out here.
Doesn't want to give the Red Wings any more rest, because, as you mentioned, Zetterberg and Datsyuk have been out a while. Is going to buy some time because he went to the bench to get a new stick, and you see Boudreau's reaction.
Well, the Ducks want this to go. They don't want the Wings resting anymore. Rather, cagey move as Cleary all of a sudden needs a new stick.
Now we're set. Edson won the last draw.
Oh, they toss them both here. Anaheim doesn't have another centerman on the ice. Daniel Winnick will take the draw here against Henrik Zetterberg as Boscherman barking at Daniel Cleary.
You surprised there aren't two centers out for the Ducks?
I'm really surprised with it.
You know, somebody got an octopus on the ice. Somebody just threw debris on the ice, which is going to give the Red Wings even more time.
So this faceoff is in the left corner, and Daniel Winnick will take it.
And now will Boudreau elect to call timeout? I think he has. Since it's all worked out that way,
you might as well call it anyway. And because you have now an unfamiliar guy taking a faceoff for you, you want to make sure everybody knows exactly where they're supposed to be. Winnick's won 30% of his faceoffs this year, hasn't taken very many of them, of course, as a winger. But now the chore will be his on that left side of the ice.
Well, the original thought was to just play on and not give the Wings a chance to catch their breath. Cleary changed that plan with this long stick change.
I believe you always have to have safety net in your zone. And with Getzlaff kicked out of the faceoff, there is no safety net. So if I'm Daniel Winnick, I'm going to have to guard against being kicked out of the draw, which is a penalty. But he has to be thinking about tie-up. Do not lose this draw cleanly to Zetterberg.
Winnick 16-37 for the faceoff circle this year. It's a minute and a half of a delay before that faceoff, and a goal. Daniel Winnick wins a draw, and the Anaheim Ducks will win game one.
What a play by Ryan Getzlaff. Winnick does exactly what he's supposed to do in that spot, where he doesn't take many draws. You don't lose it clean, you tie up. Watch Getzlaff jump into the play and save this loose puck that's sitting there. Hiller gets a long look and arms in the air as the Ducks will win game one.
With the empty net insurance. And the Ducks prevail here with a pair of goals in the third period. Stanley Cup.
The Ducks have had an excellent record at home in the regular season. They were the better team for longer. Tonight, they withstand a late Detroit push. And it's Solani's power play goal that is the difference.
Bruce Boudreau had a choice. He went with Jonas Hiller, and it was the right call as Hiller makes 21 saves in this opening game victory. Again, the final, Anaheim 3, Detroit 1. So long from Anaheim as the...